Care Hospital Management wants to calculate the charge of lab test done by its patients. Write a Python program to implement the class diagram given below. So patient and lab test laboratory, these are the two classes we have. And it has simply a list of hospital lab test IDs and list of lab test charges, both are static. And it has simply a static getter just to get lab test IDs. Then the patient class, we have patient ID, patient name, list of lab test IDs, then lab test charges. So all these are get patient ID, get patient name, get list of lab test IDs, get lab test charges. All these are getters, accessor. And this is the only method we need to focus on. Calculate lab test charge. Look at the business rule. A list of hospital lab test IDs, static list which contains list of test IDs of the lab test available in the hospital. List of lab test charges, static list which contains the charge of the lab test available in the hospital. These two lists have one-to-one correspondence. If the ID is 1, if the price is 150, if the thousand charge is 1000, then this is it has one-to-one correspondence. So there's a method, getter, get test charge, lab test ID, accepted lab test ID and return the corresponding lab test charge. Nothing else. If the test ID is invalid, return -1. Then we have list of lab test IDs, instance variable which contains the list of test IDs of the lab test done by the patient. Calculate lab test charges. We need to calculate total number of the total charges. Calculate total lab test charge based on the test charge of each lab test done by the patient. If any lab test ID provided by the patient is invalid, consider its charge to be 0. If patient has done 5 tests, so we'll have to calculate charges for all the 5 tests and give the cumulative result. Initialize attribute lab test charge with a total lab test charge. Perform case sensitive string comparison. Create objects of patient class. Calculate lab test charge on patient object. Display patient name, patient ID. IDs of lab test done by the patient and total lab test charge. So if you look at the assignment 21 and 22, they would have given the data variable, data members creation, the methods creation, all that they already had done. All we need to go is we'll have to focus on these two methods, get test charge, that is one method you need to work on, then another method, calculate lab test charge. This is what we need to work. The rest is already given by InfyTQ itself. So this is another simple static method, get test charge. It takes test ID. For example, if test ID is 101, there's a hospital lab test IDs and this is a lab test charges. If ID is 101 and the price is charges 2020. If it is 103, then 012, third portion, 123, third portion, 5700 is the charge. So these two lists have one-to-one correspondence, right? So all we need to do is we'll have to take the index lab test ID. We'll have to take the index of the lab test ID. For example, if lab test ID is 1, if some 101, the index is 0, we'll have to take the price from this list. So we take list of hospital test, we have taken the index. After finding the index, we need to return lab test charge of index. If it is the index is 0, we'll have to access this index 0. This returns 2020. Then for that, so if we are, look at this lab test IDs, these are these many list of test IDs which was performed, which a patient has undergone. So he has to give this list and name, and there's a lab test ID list, we passing it as a parameter. So for all these lab test IDs, we have to calculate charges. If something is not, look at this L105 is not there. So for that, we'll have to take 0 as a charge. We'll have to calculate for the rest of the lab test. Right, let's see how this works. Again, look at this. So these are L101, 102, these are, we are creating an object. It's a list, simply a list, which has these many tests. We assume that patient 1 is going to take up these many tests. So we create an object, object instances. A patient instance is created, okay, with the patient ID, name and lab test IDs. Then what you do, we move on to the calculate lab test charges. This is a method we are focusing on. Then we take these many for test in list of lab test IDs. List of lab test ID is this. List of lab test ID is this. So it has these many list, these many items. So we're going to take one by one. We're going to take one by one. Test ID. So it's going to take, now it is going to take 101. Look at this. Test ID is 101. Now we pass this parameter lab test repository dot get test charge. Get test charge is a static method which is part of this. Now this method will be called. Look at this. Now we check if test ID in lab test repository, whether this ID is there in the lab test repository list of hospital lab test IDs. If it is there, then we process. Otherwise, we return minus one, right? Then we take the index. We are trying to find the index of L101 is zero. It will give us zero. Index is going to be zero. With this index, we know that we will access list of lab test charge of zero, which means it will return 2020. Look at this, 2020 is returned. So we need this index, because this index and this index have one-to-one correspondence. So if you're able to access the index of one lab test ID, we can take the charge of that. Right, it returns. Then it takes, we set lab test charge. Look at this. Lab test charge now 2020. When we calculate some more, then that is also will be added to this, updated in the total. Then we take second ID. Second ID is 103. We check. Now we call this method, get lab test charge. Comes here. It checks whether 103 is there. 103 is there. If it is there, we take the index of it. Index is 2. Index is 2. So we access second index. So it is 5700. It is written. Now this value is updated. 2020 plus 5700. It comes to 7720. Then we take third one. This is how we process. 104 is there. So that is also added to the list. So it becomes plus 1320 is added. Look at this. Then we take the last index is 105, which is not there. So now it check, this will return minus 1. It return minus 1. If it is minus 1, so we check if temp, the return value is not minus 1, only then we add it. Otherwise, we simply ignore it. Then look at this. So this is the patient lab test charges. Total charges is this. Now we get patient name, we print it, we look at this. So everything is printed here. Patient ID is so, name is so, patient test IDs are these, total lab test charges are 9040. So this passes all the test cases. So you need to focus on only these two methods. Calculate lab test charge and get test charge.